As India and Indonesia agree to sign deals in a number of key areas, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Indonesian President Joko Widodo have hailed the decision to set up a joint task force to undertake projects for port-related infrastructure in and around the Indonesian island of Sabang. China has been very cautious about India and Indonesia's cooperation at the Sabang port. Sabang is located near the northwestern entrance to the Strait of Malacca, which China sees strategic for its economic and energy security. The two nations also agreed to work towards promoting sea tourism by improving connectivity between Sabang Island in Indonesia and Port Blair, as well as Havelock Island in Andaman, for promotion of sail tourism, cruise ships, marine adventure sports, diving and wellness tourism as well. Now, the decision on setting up the joint task force in Sabang comes during Prime Minister Modi's visit to Indonesia. Prime Minister Modi is in the Indonesian capital, Jakarta, as part of a five-day visit there. He is also visiting Malaysia and Singapore as a part of that tour. Let's go straight across now to our correspondent, Siddhant Sibbal, who's joining us for more on this. This is crucial given the advancements that the two countries have been looking at in these key areas. Siddhant, help our viewers understand to what extent will India actually benefit from this joint task force?
Well, connectivity is the new currency of geopolitics, and with this agreement between India and Indonesia on Sabang connecting to the Andaman Sea, this is an important development because India and Indonesia reaffirmed today that they are neighbors, they are maritime neighbors. And remember, Andaman Islands, the southernmost point of India, if we call it, the Indira Point is just 175 kilometers from the Sabang Island, which is north. And it's north of the province of Aceh, and on the mouth of the Malacca Straits. That's a very important strait because through these straits, a lot of oil, transport happens, which connects the Indian Ocean and the Pacific Ocean. So clearly, this is a new and important development that has taken place with the visit of the Indian Prime Minister, and that joined India and Indonesia together. So that is why it's important, because connectivity, that has been the focus of the current government here in New Delhi, gets a new fillip with this connectivity project that connects Sabang Island and Andaman Islands. And of course, tourism, as you have already talked, will get another boost. But other than that, the big focus is on the word Indo-Pacific, because today what has happened is that another country in Asia has joined the growing list of countries that have been accepting Indo-Pacific as the new terminology, replacing Asia-Pacific from the global diplomatic book, because Indo-Pacific means that India is a growing player, not only in South Asia, but across the Asian region. So Indonesia has been earlier dithering from accepting this word. Now, with this joint statement between India and Indonesia that has been just released a few hours ago, the word has been mentioned twice. And not only that, both Indonesia and India have come out with a new separate paper on Indonesia and India, which is the vision for India-Indonesia Maritime Cooperation. That's a separate paper just on Indo-Pacific. This, of course, has an important development because we know that China has not been not only using that word, but also against India building a port on the Sabang Island that's part of the Aceh province. Because just 2 days before the visit of the Indian Prime Minister, Global Times, that's called the mouthpiece of the Chinese Communist Party, came out with an article saying that if India builds a military post there, India will burn its fingers. That's a strong statement coming from that newspaper that's considered as the mouthpiece of the Chinese government. So clearly, this is a new geopolitical development that has happened with the visit of the Indian Prime Minister, especially focusing on connectivity and the growing usage of the word Indo-Pacific. Other than that, we saw an entire day full of a lot of events, including kites being flown by both the Prime Ministers, India
right.
and the Indonesian
I was just coming
Prime
to
Minister.
That,
this also reaffirms India's growing ties with the ASEAN.
I was just coming to that. China, of course, extremely cautious of this growing cooperation between India and Indonesia. Now, specifically with the Sabang port, as you also mentioned, China has categorically, mentioned in those editorials as well, how it is keenly monitoring those developments. So it's definitely a cooperation which will not go down too well with the Chinese side.
Well, of course, Beijing won't be happy with this development, but Beijing will not, of course, talk about what it has been doing. It has been indulging in predatory practices, predatory debt practices. Remember what has happened to that port in southern Sri Lanka that had to be leased to the Chinese for 100 years because because the Sri Lankans couldn't pay debt, and that has happened in Pakistan also. They are developing a port called Gwadar Port, and there's a string of pearls around the Indian landmass, starting from Gwadar to down south in Sri Lanka to Myanmar. And when India does something, then Beijing has this problem. Now with the development of this port, the Sabang port in Indonesia, India is getting a strategic position right on the mouth of the Malacca Straits that are crucial for trade and transport, and that joins India, Indian Ocean with the Pacific Ocean. And remember, the Prime Minister will also be going to Singapore, where he will be making that statement at the crucial defense forum, the Shangri-La Forum. That's considered the key forum when it comes to global defense outlook or global defense viewpoint. It's a think tank. There the Prime Minister will give the details of his vision of the Indo-Pacific region, a concept that's developing but that's increasingly gaining currency with the visit of the Indian Prime Minister to Indonesia.
Absolutely. We will of course keep closely monitoring the latest coming in from that a visit that's being made by the Indian Prime Minister. We're going to leave it there though for the moment. Sudhan Sibal getting us the very latest on that joint task force, close cooperation between the Indian and Indonesian sides when it comes to the Sabang port, and a development that China is not going to be too pleased with.